Recently, the Uganda People's Defense Forces passed out the first cohort of trainees to join its private security company, dubbed NEC Security Services Limited, under the National Enterprise Corporation, the commercial arm of the army. However, the development has raised eyebrows from many Ugandans. Today, it was a subject of discussion before Parliament as the Leader of Opposition, Mathias Mpuuga, imported the matter on the floor of Parliament.
Because I'm coming at the backdrop of constituting the UPDF into a fishing brigade, because they have now a fishing brigade, away from what we know of the UPDF. So will the Minister of Defence explain?
The matter has attracted criticism and endorsement from different members of parliament, as some question the legality of UPDF venturing into private guard services. A couple of lawmakers say the new venture will dent the image of the national force to look like a mercenary outfit.
But it is bad for UPDF to privatize security, because we pay money here. We pass a budget each year of nearly 4 trillion shillings. Last year we passed a budget of 3 trillion shillings just for classified itself. So this private company, who does it report to?
Because now, if it begins to do work that is meant to be done by UPDF according to the law, where does this private firm stop? Where does it start? Where does it stop?
The chief executive officer of the National Enterprise Corporation, Lieutenant General James Mujira, attempted to explain to Parliament that the security company under question is under the NEC and not UPDF.
We are talking about the National Enterprise Corporation,
no,
which is the commercial and business arm of the Ministry of Defense.
Honorable, what?
But I beg.
Honorable.
I oblige.
That is very simple. We understand what you're talking about.
That cannot happen. That would be ridiculous. Their job is to continue trading. I have told you they were running a pharmaceutical. They were running a farm. They are also running an ammunition, the neck factory in Nakasongora.
However, his submission was cut short by the Speaker, Anita Among, who instead directed the Minister of Defense, Vincent Sempija, to appear before Parliament tomorrow with a statement on the fuss around the security company.
Each member of Parliament to be aware of the guidelines that you're giving. And as I said earlier on, honorable members, you need to take a lead in this money. If you're going to leave that money to those cows, you will not get anything.
But we have also learned from the Minister Sempija that the new company will not recruit UPDF soldiers but civilians and veterans. He has also defended the creation of a private security company, saying it is within the law.
UPDF lives by an act of parliament, and therefore it is not a mercenary force at all. You cannot even equate it. It is not near. It's the Uganda People's Defense Force.
Report by Fred Kajubi for the news.